A big reason I love Final Cut Pro is the huge amount of plugins that supercharge it to get more complex looking stuff done faster. And in this video, I go over some of the plugins I find myself using constantly. I'm Rafael and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And make sure to subscribe if you like these kind of videos because I love me some plugins. The first plugin is mGrid from Motion VFX. This is meant for simulating Zoom calls or Skype calls, but I mainly use it for split screens and reveals. On the surface, it's a really simple plugin, but it is so powerful when you want to do very elegant reveals and transitions. I use it a lot for side-by-side comparisons, especially with cameras, but it allows me to have two video clips playing at the exact same time on the screen and it animates in and out. So this is the horizontal 2x1, but you can also do the horizontal 2x2. And it's very simple and intuitive to use and move the footage where you want. So with this plugin, you can actually build a full-on video wall if that's what you want it to do. I'm just gonna set it back to the 2x2, side by side. And I mostly use it for reveals like this, where I get to show a background behind or it's still animation behind. And it's a great way to reveal lists or features with footage in the background. So you can still be on screen while you're talking about a particular product that you're working with. So this is why I really like this plugin, but it also comes with avatar animations. If you're working with a lot of vertical video, this will allow you to do the same thing there. And it's just a very smooth plugin and it has all the great things that Motion VFX plugins have. It has the animate on and off, and you can actually choose different ways that it animates in. So if you wanted to blur your animation in, it will do that as well. So it's not just a slide. It actually allows you to do many different types of animations in to best suit the way you are presenting. Or you can do top and bottom split screens. It just allows for a lot of different options. Another thing I use this plugin for is picture in picture. It just adds so much more control to be able to do these kind of things relatively quickly with just this one plugin. For such a seemingly simple plugin, I use this one a lot. The next plugin that I have found myself using quite a bit, and this surprised me, is the mTracker 3D area. Now, initially I thought this was for like aerial shots or drone shots that would be useful for real estate videos, but I find myself using it for product videos where you can track in animations and build to highlight certain features. This is the kind of work that I would constantly do in After Effects, but being able to do it in Final Cut Pro relatively quickly, especially for the kind of work that I do, even just visualizing it and just doing a proof of concept, this is a great way to go about that. You do need to have mTracker 3D, the base plugin, to get all the tracking information. These are just all the different animations that can come with it. Once you have mTracker 3D, you can track the footage, you can paste the track onto the area plugin. You can simply find the area that you want to have an area marked out. And it's such a simple plugin to use where it's all rounded out. Let's say we wanted to have Mac Mini. You go over here, you add in a label and it adds in the label and you can actually adjust the rotation. So if you want to have a different kind of rotation to this title, so say you wanted it kind of floating above, have it floating above. Again, I didn't think I would use as much as I do, but I find myself going to it quite often. If I want to talk about the dimensions of a product or highlight a certain feature of it, this is a great way to achieve that very quickly, especially when I'm making YouTube videos. It allows me to highlight something very specific so the audience knows exactly what I'm talking about and it looks fantastic. Now, this plugin can be used for aerials and real estate videos. It's a more versatile plugin than I initially thought it would be for me because of the kind of stuff that I'm doing, but it really allows me to highlight things for product videos. So that's mTracker 3D Area. From time to time, Motion VFX has some big discounts and sales that go on. For instance, Black Friday and Cyber Monday, they usually have some really huge deals. So if you're in the market for these kind of plugins, that's the time to check it out. But as plugins go, these are some of the best plugins on the market for Final Cut Pro. And the amount of work and design that goes into these are, I'm always amazed with it. The next plugin I find myself using constantly is Captionator for Final Cut Pro.
This is literally what it says it is. It takes the audio from your clip and it adds captions to it. Now it can do single words, multiple words, and especially if you're doing a lot of YouTube shorts or TikTok videos or Instagram videos, this is a great way to add captions to your project in Final Cut Pro. It's a very simple plugin to use as well. Select the clip that you want, the in and out, go to share, Captionator, and then it will export the audio only and open up the Captionator as a standalone plugin. So that's exported, it processes it, and the whole, and you can adjust the way everything looks here. So I want white titles. You can add a border, and this doesn't really matter because you can actually change it after. It's just a quick way to set the style right in. You can choose your font here too, and you can add captions as well. But we're gonna leave this one-to-one word, but you can actually add multiple words if you wanted to. I'm gonna leave it one-to-one. And then two things before you hit generate, make sure you choose if you want it to be all uppercase, all lowercase, or the proper case. For pop-up titles, I use uppercase, and just make sure you have your build in or build out. It depends on what you want to do. Then you click generate, save the file where you want to save it, and it'll ask you to import it into the Final Cut project that you want to work in. You'll get a generated captions, and you can actually see that you have both captions and animated titles. But for this case, I'm just going to copy the animated titles, go into the timeline that you want to add them in. And from the endpoint that you set before, that's where you paste them. And they do come in the center. So what I typically do is I go to the properties, I position it where I want, and I copy that first one and paste it onto the rest. So I just want to make sure it's the position. And then you have
stream on my second channel where I deep dive on the creative process as well as freelance financials. So make sure you check that out. Hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.
So it's a great tool if you want to have animated captions in your videos, especially if you do lots of YouTube shorts, TikToks, Instagram reels. This is the way to get animated captions in Final Cut Pro. The next plugin is Keyper. This is a great way to isolate people from backgrounds. And it's only for people at the moment. I don't know if they'll add in objects or anything like that. But right now, it's a great way to just isolate someone from the background. This is a really good way to add text behind people, or if you want to color correct just the background, you want to do any kind of special effects on the people that are in the foreground. So in this case, if I wanted to add the text behind me, before I would have to go into After Effects and use the rotor brush or do some kind of masking, use the draw mask. But Keyper allows you to just copy the footage that you have, place it on top, and just drag it. And in most cases, you don't have to do anything to it. But you can definitely add it to high and just fine tune it until it gets to where you want it to be. And then you get text behind people. Or if I just wanted to color correct the background, it's a very quick way to be able to just color correct everything in the background without having to have any kind of weird masks. This quickly uses AI to generate the mask right on your footage. And in most cases, it's really good. I found that when people have really crazy hair or really fine detail, this plugin does struggle with that. So just be cautious of when and how you can use this plugin. But for clean lines and clothing and hats, this plugin works really well to isolate the person from the background. And finally, Color Finale, which is still one of my go-to color correction tools. If you want to do any kind of serious color correcting in Final Cut Pro, this is the plugin to have. It has a similar feel and workflow to DaVinci Resolve, if you've ever used that before. But the features that I love most about it is that it has its color management feature where you can just tell it to assume that your footage is log and boom, 95% of the work is done. Then you just go in and you can make your final tweaks to make sure that the skin tones are correct. I'm just gonna double check them here and make sure that the skin tones line up on the skin tone indicator and then turn it back on. And we have a usable image in a few clicks. This also has film emulation. If you have a color chart, it allows you to color match it to that. There's some image analysis tools, and it has color wheels, it has curves, it has your six vectors, it has the HSL curves, and so many more tools if you really want to dive into your color correction. It also has masks that you can add. It has track masks. There's so many powerful features in this plugin to get your footage the way you want it to look. Another little feature that I love about this plugin, it has an auto white balance for shots that I don't know if the color temperature was shot properly. And it has a color picker where you can just go in and choose a section that should be gray or white, and it'll white balance fairly well. And you can just do your final little tweaks after that. Just for the assume log and the auto white balance themselves are great little tools.
But the plugin is so much more powerful than that. And in this video, I do a deep dive into Color Finale and why it's my favorite. Also, I live stream on my second channel where I deep dive on the creative process as well as freelance financials. So make sure you check that out. As always, thanks for watching.